Hey Tim, I got your email, the one about leaving YouTube. And I got it like a day and a half late, so by the time I went to look at your channel, I didn't see any leaving video, which I think you had mentioned. So I'm just going to do a shoot from the hip kind of reply. And when it comes to, vlogging, or just making videos, they don't have to be vlogs. Just creating something that you put on video. I think the principal reason why I do it is to get it done, to create something, and then the important part too, to get it out there that someplace that's beyond my office, to put it someplace just out of my reach for a while so that it can be on its own, to know that, not only did I create something, but that, I put it on a little shelf somewhere, and it's over here now, and I can go and make something else. And if you have that attitude, I really don't see why there has to be a constant end time to the process, to your memberships, for example. If you're just doing it to create something, and then to put it on its own little place, and then to move on, it's really a process that can go on indefinitely. However, when other things get mixed up with it, like you are too much affected by the comments something might get, you're too much affected by a low number of views or things like that, then I just think it's time to refocus. It's not time to terminate, it's not time to end, and it doesn't have to be a process that takes up any more time than you want to give it. I can see where being in an environment like Vloggerheads was, especially toward the end, is going to hamper that whole process, and I can see why you would want to leave. But if we're just speaking about it in general, especially, something as, what can I say? Innocuous, informal, something as distant, as YouTube, where you can put it, whatever kind of settings you want on your videos that can either be seen by anybody who can find it or be seen by only the people who have the link or whatever, then there's no such, pressure. You can set it so that nobody can comment or thumbs up or thumbs down on your videos, which is another thing that has puzzled me, because I know stuff like that gets to you and bugs you, as it rightly should, because I can relate to that, it would me, yet you don't use those settings. You don't make it so that you won't get the negative, thumbs down, or nobody can comment or stuff. And it's like an undoing, Like, if that's the type of stuff that gets you to say fuck it, and let you enable that setting so that everybody can do the thing that makes you say fuck it, well, your other choice was not to enable those settings, So maybe there's a deeper process going on, and you look at vlogging as a transitory nothing. Not as a diary entry. Certainly not written on paper, because paper stays, right? This is the equivalent of writing a diary entry and then just torching it, a few days later, which I suppose can be therapeutic for the soul if you're just looking at it from you, from that point of view. But if you look at it from the art, you're just killing and killing and killing the art. So if you create something, no matter what you think of it, right? No matter what somebody else thinks of it, if you've completed it, you've made a video, and you put it out there, just think of it as putting it on a shelf. And if you don't want the passers-by to comment on it, you have those settings on YouTube, and that doesn't have to happen. So that's my first, reaction to your email about leaving YouTube and vlogging changing and things like that. We go around the circle a lot, People are always going to do personal journals forever. People living out in space 1,000 years from now are going to keep a personal journal, and it'll be a 3D hologram that plays on a little table somewhere. I don't know, but it will be there. And so to say that vlogging is dying, vlogging is ending, you know, what's the point? And maybe that's an internal limitation, you know? And the whole thing with vlogging is, you just do it the way you want to do it, and you don't worry about other people. And you use whatever is available to make you okay with that process. Because once you've created it, and you give it that little space, you get it out there, get it out of your room, get it out of your house, just put it on a shelf out there in the internet, and move on. You don't want to go back and destroy it. You know, you want to look at it as something that's just like burning your diary. I mean, what's the point of keeping a diary if you just keep on burning it? You know, 10 years from now, maybe you'll think they're worth nothing, but at least you'll be able to see what you looked like in 3D moving around and talking in a video way back when. I don't know. There's more than one way to look at it, right? But you got to do what's right for you, and if for whatever reason it's just getting you down to the point where you leave L'Oasis and you take your stuff off of YouTube and vlogging and video making, you think it's over, and well, alright, fair enough, you know. But should you come back to it, I'd urge you to consider that kind of just a two-step outlook, really simple. Enjoy creating something. Once it's done, once you've made the video, consider just putting it on that shelf out there and just leaving it. You have infinite storage. You don't have to go making room for anything. You just move on. You just forget about it, because destroying it doesn't make much of a statement as far as history is concerned. It only makes a statement to the people who noticed it was there. And if it's not there for long, not many people are going to notice. And it's okay not to care about those things, but it's just a much healthier way to go, to let it stay alive, so to speak. When you open it up, right, so that anybody can comment and anybody can give it thumbs down, you have to recognize this as one of your triggers, right? Just as it would be a trigger for me. I don't like getting thumbs down. I don't like getting negative comments. And if it disturbs you to the point of tearing all your stuff down, then please, in the future, should you post videos, take the precaution of using those settings so that people can't do the thumbs up and that people can't comment. You can still make it so anybody can see it, but you can just do those selective settings. And I'd really urge you to do that, because it seems like it's the comments and stuff, like when you were on Vloggerheads the last time, you wrote to me that John said it was sad or something, which, you know, on the meter of offensiveness, sad isn't, you know, terribly high. It's just, you know, a negative comment. But apparently you left, like, not too long after that. So if things like that would bother you, please, I urge you, you know, in the future, should you make and post videos, take the steps that are going to avoid this kind of situation happening again. It's just the cycle of making and creating, when it should be a cycle of making and moving on and letting the things, you know, be, you know? Yeah. If artists created songs and then destroyed them, you know, if the writers wrote books and then burned them, I mean, where the hell would we be? You're not the only one to judge the merit of something you create. You know, other people can judge its merit, and they aren't all going to be negative. There are some people who really hope that you'd have your stuff preserved, and consistently, when they see it destroyed, it's dismaying. So, just passing that on, humbly. I don't want to fucking lecture. I'm just letting you know how I feel, and I appreciate getting the emails, and I hope you reconsider. You know, it in whatever capacity, you know, that we're making stuff, L'Oasis is still there. It's perplexed me as to why the limiting factor couldn't be employed so that you just did it whenever you felt like it, or you weren't even active, but you were just a member. You know, the whole point of closing your account is, to me, if you're pissed off with the site. You know, if you're pissed off with the people there. But I would hope that you weren't in the case of L'Oasis. maybe it really was that dispute you had with Laurie over the Jews in Hollywood. I really don't know. But if it's none of that, and you're doing it because you think vlogging is dying, well, come on, man. Just see if it dies, you know? You don't have to be the Nostradamus here. Just see what happens, you know? All right. Rant over. Cheers, my friend.